Hi, I'm Anne Nwawodo. Here's your Channel's TV Morning News Update for September the 21st, 2019. The federal government has filed 7 counts of treasonable, felony and money laundering against the convener of the Revolution Now protest, Mr. Omoyele Sowore, the chief state counsel to the Department of Public Prosecutions of the Federation. The Federal Ministry of Justice, Mr. Aminu Alilu, signed the charges on behalf of the Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, Mr. Abubakar Malami. Mr. Sowore was charged along with one other, Olawale Bakare. Staying in the nation's capital, the Monetary Policy Committee of the Central Bank of Nigeria is asking the federal government to consider the sale of its redundant public assets as part of efforts to increase its revenue base. Addressing a news conference, the CBN governor, Mr. Godwin Emefiele, applauded the federal government's plan to increase the value-added tax from 5% to 7.5%. And in Lagos, a petrol tanker has fallen at the Otedola bridge access of the Lagos-Ibadan expressway, spilling its content. The timely arrival of fire services prevented the ignition of the highly flammable content, while the accident caused a build-up of traffic along the route. On the international scene, U.S. President Donald Trump has denied a report alleging he made a promise to a foreign leader, something that sparked a whistleblower's formal complaint. The complaint is reported to relate to a July phone call with Ukraine's new president Volodymyr Zelensky, but Mr. Trump dismissed the claims as fake news. And in sports, Zinedine Zidane is under pressure at Real Madrid following the 3-0 defeat at Paris Saint-Germain, according to ESPN FC sources. After winning 3 straight Champions League titles, the Frenchman left his post in the summer of 2018, only to return in March 2019 after his replacement, Yolen Lopetegui, and subsequently Santiago Solari, were sacked. And that's the morning news update. Don't forget to join us later for the evening recap. Thank you for watching. I'm Anne Nwawodo.